Good afternoon, everyone. We are here now again with another exercise on interpreting and shadowing. This time we are combining both abilities in order to demonstrate how these two abilities combine to produce translation of the message in one original language into a second language, which is going to be our target language. This time I am going to shadow on the sermon of Bishop T.D. Jakes. The sermon is named "The Power to Pull People Out." You are trying to be the kind of believer.
Get up and leave the service right now, because I don't have a sermon.
Because I don't have a sermon for you. I have a message for people who are willing to disrupt some things, to be in the will of God. I came to talk to people who are tired of church as usual, and they are ready for church unusual. They are ready to go to the next level, and they are willing to be radical and be labeled radicals and even heretics, because you know what God has spoken in your life, and you're willing to stand on the word of God rather than the free friends and the people around you. Now understand that there was great controversy existing at this point in the next in Jerusalem, where was a great discord that was much terrible. Jesus had shaken everything up, stepped on the scene, shaking things up. The religious people despised him. He was very controversial. It's difficult for us to understand that, because we worship him and we totally accept him and embrace him. But in the time that Jesus ministered in, he was extremely controversial. He was greatly disliked by the majority of religious people, and he came in and started ministering and spent a little over 3 years ministering and moved out of there and left everything shaken, said, "I'm turning it over to you. Whoever told you that if you accept Jesus Christ, everything is going to be calm, lie. Jesus will shake up anything he gets. He will shake up everything. If you want everything to be calm and quiet, don't fool with the Lord. Because if the Lord comes around, he will shake up everything, mess up all your plans. He'll fool with your finances. You're going to put guilt. No, put it over there. Going to go to the university. He'll say, no, I want you to go over there. He'll turn your life around. He'll get all your business. Tell who you marry, who not to marry. He gets in your sex life. He gets in your personal life. And don't mind if get real. We'll get in everything. If you are too loud, he'll tell you to calm down. If you are too calm, he'll tell you to get up and praise me. He has a way of breaking rules in your life. He's radical.
Once he stirred everything up, he turned it over to the disciples.
And these disciples had to be wise. Oh God, give us wise men. We've got great men and big men and big name men, but we need wise men. We need men who are balanced. Mature believers is somebody who is balanced and not going to either extreme. The church has a tendency to swing like a pendulum from one extreme to the other, but you need to come to the point that you are balanced. Ahora viene la interpretación. Now comes the interpretation of this segment of the speech. It is a very intense speech, very passionate speech. It has lasted 3 minutes and 26 seconds. And what I'm going to do now is trying to recall what I understood from the previous part of the speech. He is calling the people to understand that in the time that Jesus was in on earth, and the time when Jesus was ministering in, he encountered a lot of opposition towards him and towards his message, because there were two different things. Towards him, due to his attitudes, due to the way he used to serve people, to heal people in the streets or during the day of rest, the Shabbat, and opposition against what he said, what he commented on the religious system at that particular time. Furthermore, the bishop speaks about the condition in which the Christian believer are, the Christian believers are today inside the church. He has mentioned that people has become comfortable inside the church, and there is a lot of work to do outside the church, not only inside the church. That he, you go to the church in order to learn, but you have to go outside the church in order to apply what you have learned in the church. While some model of people are used to go to the church and do nothing about the situation and the condition and with the people that is outside the church. After all, he says that the church has this idea of swinging among two extreme positions, that like a pendulum, but he is telling too that in the church there is a great need for balanced people, for people who do not swing either for one side or the other, but people who are balanced, people who are standing firmly in one position and that are able to go from the core of the church towards the field of spiritual welfare. Actually, after watching at my own video, I can understand my failures at both speaking in English alone, understanding the message, and compressing the message into its different segments, and after that organizing those segments into almost the same sequence of thoughts given by the original person. So we ran on 3 minutes of speech. And in the next 3 minutes, I'm going to take the message, the original message in English, and I'm going to turn it into Spanish. I'm going to go pausing the video in order to take the message and say it into Spanish. Let's hear.
But they were not interested in discord. They still had not given up on their Judaistic brothers and were willing to come into hostile environments for the...
Pedro y Juan todavía no estaban en la contradicción, pero y sin embargo estaban ya con la visión de tomar el mensaje y de irse a territorio hostil para aplicarlo.
Benefit of winning some. They were willing to come into hostile rooms where there were eyes being rolled at them, people sneered.
Ellos estaban deseosos de llegar a lugares hostiles donde la gente estaba haciendo gestos de disgusto y donde la gente se burlaba.
And everybody was not accepting of them because they knew that he that winneth souls is wise.
Y la gente no estaba de acuerdo con esta actitud de ir al campo y ganar almas. Es lo que necesitamos ahora, gente balanceada. No tan liberales que ellos han perdido todos los estándares. Y no tan legalistas que ellos nos toman de regreso hacia la ley judía original. Sino gente que puede permanecer en una interpretación balanceada de lo que Cristo es. Y así vemos a Pedro y Juan, donde ellos vienen a la hora de la oración, ellos vienen y vienen a esta atmósfera volátil. Mucha gente eran adoradores, mucha gente estaban sospechosos, sospechaban de ellos, y mucha gente creía en los poderes de Jesucristo. Muchos de ellos pensaban que él era un herético, y en ese clima es que ellos llegaron y ellos hicieron su primer camino, y ahí ellos venían porque la gente hoy, si tú no, tú no estás de acuerdo con lo que la gente dice, ellos no pueden venir y adorar contigo. Si yo quiero decir lo siguiente, que si tú no te amarras los zapatos de la forma en que ellos se amarran los zapatos, ellos se salen y se apartan de la iglesia. No estoy hablando de cualquier cosa que esté pasando en Oklahoma, sino en Texas, donde la gente sale de una iglesia a causa de un peinado o de un maquillaje o de los aretes o de los papeles higiénicos o de los de las cintas de zapatos o de la comunión, de las copas del bautismo, o de cualquier cosa que ellos utilizan para salirse de la iglesia. Hemos olvidado que nosotros no somos no estamos hablando a personas que no pueden recordar. Nosotros somos personas que estamos esencialmente en una misión. No podemos darnos el lujo de comprometer nuestra misión por las actitudes de la gente y sus conceptos. Tienes que hablar la verdad y mantenerte en marcha. ¿Estás oyendo lo que estoy diciendo? Dice que Pedro y Juan venían a la hora de la oración y en el camino encontraron a este hombre cojo que estaba en la puerta llamada La Bella. Es un hombre interesante porque él estaba detenido afuera de la manía religiosa, del tumulto religioso, y él estaba fuera y él no se había involucrado, no se había vuelto parte de esto. Y tú tienes que entender que cuando nosotros nos encaminamos hacia el lugar de adoración, el más grande ministerio ocurre fuera.
Y
Y si tú no entiendes esto, tú nunca vas a entender quién es lo quien tú quieres, tú necesitas ser en el Señor. Tú vienes a la iglesia y te vuelves un frustrado acerca de la oportunidad de escuchar, de hablar, de cantar tu canción, de dar tu alabanza, y tú no entiendes que tú estás aquí para ser visto y tú no viniste aquí para ser oído, y esta iglesia no estaba construida para ti, para tener una plataforma para explotar tus dones y talentos. Este es un campo de entrenamiento. Este es un campo de preparación. Esta es una operación militar. Cuando tú miras que nosotros venimos de esta forma, esta es una convocación. Estás en un cuarto de discusiones. Ahorita tú estás en un cuarto de discusiones espirituales para que tú puedas leer los memorándums y tú puedas ejecutar tu trabajo afuera de estas puertas. This was an attempt to make a consecutive translation from the sentences that the pastor was speaking. And it was from the original language, which is English, towards the target language, which is Spanish. Esta es una oportunidad muy interesante porque adicionalmente, this is a very interesting opportunity because in addition to this exercise, I am trying to grasp new ideas and new ways to express ideas to arrange them together in order to give useful and meaningful messages for the people who you are interested to speak with. Thank you very much. I'm going to leave it here. I have plenty of things to do today. I have plenty of planning, plenty of arranging other things, but this is my training log. Actually, by the day Monday, year 2022, January the 10th. Thank you, and let's go learning more and more. Thank you all.